just go to their feet. There you go.
Okay.
Ella's gonna help me with questions and answers and everything, but as you can see, go ahead and look that way for me. So she's got your typical mullet. It's grown out. She had sides shaved at one time. And I think what happens is we have trends, and trends come and go, but I think sometimes we hold on to them for too long. And really a trend is just there for a season. So what I want to do is kind of bring this into something that's a little more on trend for spring, summer. But Ella also wants to grow her hair out. So I want to make sure that this is in a structure and a shape for her to just let it grow. I know a lot of times as hairdressers, we get into this thing where we try to get our clients back like every 6 weeks, 6-8 weeks. I operate a little differently. I like to see my clients seasonally. So spring haircut, summer haircut, fall haircut. That way it grows into something else and we're into a new season and we can look at it from a whole new perspective. So your consultations are a little more solid. It's not like, oh, I just saw you 6 weeks ago. It's like, oh, you know, how was your spring? What are we gonna do for summer? So I just like to let their hair grow, and then when it's they come back in for the next one, it's a whole new haircut. Because I'm old, and the worst thing you can say is do what you did last time, because I don't remember what I did last time. So I want to do something different and something new. Elle has amazing hair. You'll see it has a little curl to it once we get it wet. Again, we had the consult. She wants to grow it, but there's key areas I want to adjust so that she can do that. Her top gets a lot of weight in it, so I want to go ahead and debulk the top. So basically what we're going to end up with is a really soft bowl cut or halo. I love the classics. At Armco, we love the classics. Classics never go out of style. It's never a trend. You can wear them any season, any year. And that old school halo haircut from Sassoon is great, but I wanna change things up a little bit. I'm gonna do mine with a razor. Now, if you're into Hairbrand and you're here all the time, you'll know that Gerard did a razor cut yesterday, and he went from the, really described what the razor does. So I wanna kind of move beyond that and say, okay, we know how the razor works. How do we apply it? So that's what we're going to work on. Since everybody's going to ask, I am using a feather plié. It's an old school one, so you probably noticed the old green handle. I prefer this over a guarded razor because I just feel I have more control. It's a thinner blade. And it just feels better in my hand. The sticks are fine, you can use it, but I tend to find myself being heavy-handed. So like I said, Elle's gonna keep track of any questions and everything. If you can't see something, let me know. But we are gonna dive right in. I've got an hour to do this, and what's nice is, because we already had such a solid consultation, I already know where I'm going, so the haircut will actually go quite quick, so I'm gonna try to slow down a little bit. So yeah, let's get going. I'm gonna spin you real quick here. Make sure you guys can see some of this. I don't have anybody working the camera, so I'm gonna try to do this as best as possible. Cool. So I'm just misting her hair down. I don't want it soaking wet, but I also don't want it dry. And then what I'm gonna use is the Essential Hair Tonic by R&Co Blue. I like this because it gives me some slip to the hair, but without making it like too slick, I still have some grip to it. It smells amazing. and it puts a ton of shine to the hair, which you'll probably see in a bit. I'm gonna move my light here. I'm gonna turn on my other camera too, since I forgot to do that. You were supposed to remind me.
I was supposed to remind you. You relied on the wrong person.
That's all right. That's all right. I'm filming this with another camera, and I forgot to turn it on. Okay, go ahead and turn it on. Yeah. There you can make comments. I like the delay on that. So just starting with the center section. I want to make sure you guys can see. There we go. You know, keeping it simple, center section, a little bit wetter. For me, I like to start where the most important part of the haircut is. And for Elle, it's going to be the hairline. So I want to start here. If I was like cutting her bangs first and that was the focal point, then I'm going to start there. Joshua, what is it, like 3 a.m. there? Mm-hmm. Joshua's incredible. He attends like every one of our classes, and he's in Taiwan, so it's morning there, like really early in the morning. It's probably already Friday there, I think. So what I'm gonna do is take my razor, I'm gonna have So what I'm going to do on the hairline is I don't want this blunt.
Montana says hello from Big Island, Hawaii.
Ooh, cowabunga, my friend. So I want this hairline soft. I don't want it hard. I don't want it blunt, which is if I go in with scissors, that's what I'm going to get. So I'm actually going to turn L just a little bit so you can see the profile. I'm letting her hair naturally split where it wants to. Make sure you guys can see that. Bring your head up just a little bit. You can see where her hairline wants to split. So I'm gonna tackle each one of those individually. And what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to, with her head down, I'm gonna pull this straight out. And I'm gonna use the flat part of the blade, or the middle part. And I want this first section to be quite close. So I'm actually gonna put the blade right up to her head. And then I'm gonna start working this blade, this cut out, fairly wide stroke. That's what you get. So I want to make sure you guys can see. I'll just grab the camera. You can see how soft that is. That's what I want because number one, it's going to look incredibly feminine, very soft, but it's also going to grow out nice. There's not an edge to grow out. But what I did was because her head's down and I pulled this straight out, I'm actually graduating it. Get a better angle. Straight out. And I don't know if you guys can see my little finger. It's resting on her. That's my anchor. So my hand's not gonna go anywhere. If I let it go, my section can go anywhere. So always try to anchor yourself right up to the head, just like before. Nice wide stroke. Yeah. Go ahead and bring your head up a little bit. But you guys can see how soft that is, and that's what I want. And again, this is my first section. And this section is everything. If you can do a great hairline on a client, you will have a client for life. Nice wide stroke. creeper in here.
Valeria says hello, thank you for representing
our group. You are very welcome. Is that Valeria? Nice.
Yeah, Valeria.
Valeria, looking forward to seeing you in Miami soon. So now we're just getting a nice, soft hairline. Bring the next section in. Now, because this is going to be a halo shape, I am going to be following her head shape and her hairline and her growth pattern. Grabbing some more tonic by R&Co Blue. Smells great, right? So now I'm gonna keep following this idea of this graduation up to the occipital bone. Her occipital bone sits quite low, which is actually fantastic for this haircut, because I don't want a bowl this way. I want a bowl this way, so it's like a bit more 70s. So I'm gonna pull this section straight out just like the first one, but I can see what I just cut underneath it. I can see through it. So I'm gonna start where I ended the first section, and I'm just gonna work my way out. Nice long strokes on the blade. The shorter the stroke, the more blunt the edge. The wider the stroke, the softer the edge. And again, if you guys can see, I'm not over directing this back. I'm pulling it straight out from where it grows because I want the shape to follow her growth pattern. And you want a nice, light hand. Don't get heavy-handed with the blade. That's the key with a razor, is it's soft, it's gentle, it's like you're painting. So keep it that way. But if you want to get aggressive, get aggressive. So her hairline on this side grows quite strong. So again, that's the direction I'm going to pull it. Soft. It's brilliant. What I find great about trends is that number one, they're short-lived, and number two, they travel. So, like something that's trending in Italy or Milan might not hit New York, LA till the next season. And then it travels from there, when they're done with it, travels inward. So Middle America might get it the season after that. So you get to see it for quite a while, even though the hairdressers in other places have moved on. So now that I'm at the occipital bone, I'm actually going to, instead of pulling it out from the head, I'm going to pull it down and use more of the edge to start creating my guide or my perimeter.
Snickersnacks would like to know, what's the angle you're keeping your blade, and do you ever cut dry with the blade?
Cool. And I want you to say that name again.
Snickersnacks.
That is awesome. That's the one great thing about social media, is you can just like call yourself whatever you want. Unless that's your real name. So to answer that question, which is a great question, what angle am I holding my blade? Why that's such a great question is because a lot of times when I watch people razor cut, they have the blade flat to the hair. That's fine, but you're going to get a lot of weight removal on those ends. So it will actually weaken the shape. If that's what you want, cool. But usually I'll have it parallel with the section and angled slightly so that I make sure that I'm cutting on the edge of the blade and not the flat. So I don't know if you can see this, but I'll try to make sure that you guys do. Let's try this angle. So there's my section. Instead of pulling it out where I'm getting super strong graduation, it would be layering if her head was up, but because it's down, if she brings her head up, I'm graduating, not layering. So this way, I'm pulling it down, still graduation, but softer, or stronger, I should say. And then the blade is sitting, so I'm cutting on the edge. It's hard to see in the camera, I know that, and I do apologize. You see, now I'm starting to get my line. Sneaker snaps.
Mm-hmm.
So good.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't we used to do that with like MySpace?
Mm-hmm.
Like come up with a name. I miss MySpace. Anybody else miss MySpace? You don't want to go back to it. It's like you spend hours and days and weeks and months getting your background right, making sure the right song comes on when someone goes to your page. Like those were good days.
Better than Facebook for sure.
So I'm still working it up. I'm just now one section above her occipital bone. And again, my sections are following her growth pattern. I know COVID's a thing, but I really don't want to talk about it. I think we're all tired, especially as hairdressers. Kind of been through hell over the last year. So I think it's just good that we take a break. So that's my public service announcement. It's time to get back into education. It's time to start playing again. At least that's what I think. So I'm just using the tip of the blade to remove some weight. Some people call it tipping. Just using the blade to tap the weight out of my section. But the big thing with this is I don't want it to look like too much like a graduated bob because we are going shorter. Any other questions or anything?
No, a lot of comments about
everybody loves
my space,
though. Right? See? It's a thing. I'm right. And I know, like, especially talking about education, all of us at Arnco are, you know, we've been doing really good at doing education online, and that's been super beneficial. But I think we're all ready to get back on the road, all the educators. So I think sometime soon, you're gonna see us all back in your salons. And I know the boys, the collective, Howard, Garen, Tom, Richie, I know we're all ready to get back into your guys' world and invite you into ours. Just doing a little adjustments on our hairline. Just making sure it's going where I want it to go. I'm gonna keep working this up to her crown. How many people still have their MySpace? Do you still have yours?
No.
Oh.
Long ago.
I still have mine.
Oh, that's awesome.
I still get emails. People like, so-and-so friended you on MySpace. I was like, well, that's great.
That's amazing.
I haven't been to it, though. Probably still has the cheesy leopard or zebra print background.
That's beautiful.
Right?
Alexander would like to know if this live will be available to you later.
Yep. Yes, Alexander, it will. I'll make sure to the Hairbrain people publish it. Which basically means I'll publish it as soon as I'm done. How's that hairline looking, guys? It's good, right? I think that's like the coolest part with the razor, is that the haircut looks lived in. Like, if I need to do a blunt cut, if I need to do a precision haircut, not that this isn't precision, but I think you guys know what I'm talking about, then I'll do it. But I just tend to like things to move. You know, I don't want a haircut to do one thing. I want a haircut to do everything. So if she wants to wear it straight, she can wear it straight. If she wants to wear it curly, she can wear it curly. If she wants to push it back, push it forward. Like, I want it to do everything.
Yeah, Sheila said razor cutting is my favorite, and thank you for doing this class. I needed some different ideas and approach to my razor cutting. Love the hairline.
Who is it?
Sheila.
Sheila, thanks for that, and I think we all agree on that one. We all need to get out of the box. Anytime I say get out of the box, all I think of is like that movie Seven.
Yes.
What's in the box?
What's in the box?
So you notice I haven't had her lift her head up because I want to keep this, like if I bring her head up, I'm probably going to end up pulling this section out too far, too high, and it's going to end up again looking like a graduated bob. I want this to look like a halo, so I'm keeping her head down. Make sure that my sections are all going into the same spot. Now there's some weight in here that I want to remove. That just looks very solid to me inside. So I'm gonna take the blade and I'm gonna go inside and I'm just gonna carve out those little bits. Looks like that. So because I took this one solid piece and broke it up into three smaller bits, now I can go in and just put my line in.
Joshua would like to know when will you have a photo shoot and razor cut course together?
Soon, pal. I hope soon. And the photo shoot bit, that's a biggie. Anybody who knows Arnco knows we are all about documentation and filming, and photographing. It's a big part. And I remember a while back I did a makeover class in LA, in Hollywood, and I had so much fun doing it. And it's really because I had such a great group. And we did that for Arnco. And I really want to do another one of those. Because getting into a room with a photographer and being able to really see how to photograph is key, especially with Instagram and social media, getting photos on your website. All that is super important.
Snickersnacks would like to know the blades that you use, because some that he uses are not pleasing to use and yours looks really smooth.
Okay, do you mean the blade or do you mean the actual razor? The blade is Feather. And I think this is where Feather razors really win, because the blade is second to none. It's thin, it's sharp, it's clean. And then my razor itself is a razor plié. You've probably seen these, but with a black handle. You can also have companies make you a custom handle. This one's a wood one from the Great Lakes Razor Company. But Feather razors only take Feather blades. And that's really, you know, where Feather succeeds, I think. Like, you just can't get a better blade. But I think we can make a better razor. Howard McLaren has been talking a lot about improving this design, and I hope someday he gets the chance. If you don't know Howard, Howard's one of our founders, my mentor, definitely. We've worked together for almost 25 years now, and he's got some great ideas, and I really hope that they come to fruition. So I want to make sure you guys can see my shape. Again, classic halo, but softer instead of being so blunt. And also with the halo, we would have started from the front classically and worked our way back. I'm starting from the back and working my way forward. The reason why is because this is the most important part. All this is just shaping, but this was where we were getting rid of the mullet. No more mullet. So I got up, so you can see, I'm up here at the lower crown. Go ahead, bring your head up, perfect. That's where I'm gonna stop, because this is shorter. So I'm just gonna let that be for right now until I get the front and the sides done, because that will tell me what I can do with the interior. It's okay not to know exactly what you're going to do, because if you have a strong foundation, I know what I want this to be, but once you get into this hair, you don't know what it's gonna do. So it's allowing yourself that room to react to it. And once you get really experienced, you can start from scratch, maybe not know where you're going. You gotta do that with select clients, but can't do that with everybody, they're paying you money. But you can get a model in and go, you know what, let's just start cutting hair and see where we end up. Because you've got strong technique. That's one thing we really strive for at Arn Co. is taking that strong technique, that addiction to the classics, and seeing where we can push them. So it's like, you could be doing a bob. You know how to cut a bob. Try cutting it differently. Try using a different tool. Try angling your sections different. Where's that gonna take it? But when it comes down to it, the most important part of a haircut is not your scissors, it's not your razor, it's not your comb. It's the person sitting in the chair. And if whatever you do doesn't fit them in that character, it's all wrong. So I am going to take a section just below the parietal ridge, because I know I want to keep this top heavy. So I'm not going to come up to it where it's balanced. I want it unbalanced. I want most of the weight up here. So now, you can see the line, and we know where that needs to go. So it's just following that line. sure you guys can see. At least somewhat. You know, I'm gonna put my elbow in front of it. So what I've done is I've sectioned the hair where I have my back, sectioned it right in the middle of the ear. And then I have this bit. I wanna make sure I have some of that. Now I don't want a bob, I want a halo. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna comb this down, and almost like the old firefly, I'm gonna kick it forward. So pulling it straight down, move it forward. Probably see better on this side. If I make you dizzy, let me know.
You're good.
All right.
Joshua would like to know, have you used razor to do scissors overcomb on man's very short haircut?
Absolutely. So the question was, if nobody got that, was have I used scissors or used a razor to do basically razor overcomb like you would scissor overcomb? The answer is yes. It keeps it very soft. You know, anything you can do with your scissors, you can do with your razor. You can even cut a fairly blunt line with a razor. So yeah, you can definitely do razor over comb. So I wanna make sure you guys can see my line is following. Now, if I combed it straight down, I'd end up with a bob or an old school bi-level, depending on where I put the sides. But because I combed it down and then brought it forward, now it wants to travel with that angle. So again, I'm not going to touch the top yet. I've got my line, I'm actually quite happy with it. So this is the fun part. This is where we usually say, do the same thing on the other side. But as we all know, that is impossible because this is a different side. I don't care where you go to yoga. It's a different body position. It's a different everything. So we need to start looking at it as different. It's a cop-out to me to say, do the same thing on the other side. It's like, no. Because as we all know, with growth patterns, one side does one thing, the other side does the exact opposite. It's that whole yin and yang philosophy. So it's like if this side grows that way, guaranteed this side is growing forward. So same idea on the section, splitting it right in the middle of the ear. Not where the ear meets the head, but the middle, because I want this to over-direct slightly so I don't get that hole, right? Nothing's worse, I think we all can agree. You're working on a bob or a strong line like this, and it all looks great, and then you blow it out, and you got that little hole right above the ear, and then you end up recutting it. So again, pulling this straight down and then just moving my hand forward. That will put me in a great position for that line.
Joshua would like to see you do that razor-scissor demonstration soon.
I will try to get a short-haired guy or a really short-haired girl to demo that.
And everybody's loving the demonstration.
Oh, cool. What time is it?
It is 10:30.
Perfect. Actually, not perfect. I'm still ahead of schedule. That's okay. It just means we can play with the styling. So I want to make sure you guys can see where we're at. I'll take you on a tour. Again, we just did the perimeter. In case anybody wants to know, I'm at Bourgeois Studios in Spokane, Washington. Basically, it's my fortress of solitude. This is where I do photos and video, haircut. I really love her bangs. I mean, it just, the way they are now reminds me of Hair Show. Because it's like, we always do that on stage, right? Heavy, heavy fringe. Or we just cut all the fringe off. So what I'm gonna do now is just make sure that my line is connecting to the fringe or bangs, depending on where you're at. I know that's always a bone of contention. It's bangs, it's fringe, it's whatever you want it to be. It could be George for all I care. Mm. We all know what we're talking about.
Louise says, hey from London.
Hey, Louise. See, fringe, right? Right, Louise? Fringe. Whenever I'm teaching over there, I always have to go, okay, fringe, mm-hmm. not bangs, fringe. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is start removing the weight from the top. We know that it gets a bit clumpy in here for her, and I want her to be able to just let this air dry or power dry it. But so I wanna get some weight out of here. I don't necessarily wanna remove length, but I do want to remove weight. So what I've done is started where I left off, which is the lower crown. And I am going to cut or section, a center section from that bit. Go ahead and tip your head down.
Oh, okay.
There you go. I don't know if you guys can even see that. So center section, I just realized it's kind of a crap center section, so let's do this again. I don't know if you guys do that. If you take a crap section, call yourself out on it and redo it. It's really easy, especially if you're working with a client that you're like, they don't know, but you know, and the hairdresser working next to you knows. So it's like, do it right. All right, so now I'm gonna take this section. Making sure, like I said, I don't wanna take out really any length, but I wanna break it apart. So I'm gonna take the blade, tip it upside down. For those of you that haven't gone through much razor cutting classes, it's like sipping tea, pinky up, right? Girls do this really easy. Guys tend to have a hard time. Once you get it, you get it, but really practice that because you want that blade straight up and down. Not too much this, more of that. So I'm gonna come up, look at what the inside is, bring my blade in, and just use the flat of the blade to break that apart. That's what I get. I'm bringing this section straight up, no over direction. I'm just bringing it up to my fingers so I'm about that far away from the ends of her hair because I don't want to thin out the ends. I'm trying to thin out the interior. So now, for those Sunnis out there, I'm gonna go in here like the moosh, which is this is my center point, and I'm just going to take pie sections all the way through so that it follows her head shape.
Just lots of love.
Love, love. All you need is love. John Lynn. So again, I'm just pivoting, right? And then bring that guy in. I'm gonna have her lean her head towards me. And pull it straight out from where it grows. And again, all I'm doing is taking the weight out to break up the shape, because I don't want a space helmet. I still want the shape, but I don't want it solid. Because when the wind blows, I want this to move. Now, I'm to the section that's just behind the ear. And I actually love this section because it looks amazing. Right? So again, I'm just taking that solid piece, combing it straight out from where it grows, breaking it apart. This is also the same way for you, all the people that love wigs. It's almost the same way you'd layer a wig, because a wig stitching is across. So you can't layer it on the ends. You have to layer it on the inside. So now I've done that section behind the ear, and I'm going to keep pivoting. To break this shape up. Yeah.
Says it looks
great. Scarpacey?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, buddy. I will be riding the bike. I don't know if it's going to be this year, but I will be riding the bike down Pacific Coast Highway. And I want to come see you, but I'm also planning a trip to Palm Springs and Joshua Tree. So I would love to see you guys. Again, not removing any length. Just taking the weight out, going from that center section in the crown. Blade straight in. Debulk. It's like same sections as a moosh. If the Sassoonies out there know what that is. I think it's like only the Sassoonies know what the moosh is. So I brought it up in classes and everybody looks at me funny. So what did he just say? What's a moosh? Moosh is a great cloth. I mean, it's for me, it's one of the classics. I don't think it like qualifies like a bob or graduated bob or pixie or firefly halo, but moosh is great because the entire haircut is done from the inside out. So if you don't know what it is, look it up. And that's just going to lead me right back to my center section that I started. Sweet. Now, if you're going to do haircuts like this, find yourself a model that looks just like this. So I'm very fortunate to have Elle do this for me. We did a class for R & Co. on Zoom. I think it was on Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
And we did a 80s reference of the New Romantics. And I was like, after editing the photos, I was like, how lucky was that? Elle does makeup, So I always know her makeup's gonna be like the balm.
Thank you.
And it kind of brings me to having house models. At Arnco, we're really fortunate. We have Laura who gets us our models. She knows our taste. She knows what each one of us likes. Howard wants an alien. I tend to kind of lean, I think, towards like classic features, especially like big eyes. I just love big eyes. In your salon, you should have house models. And these are kids, boys, girls, who they never pay for a haircut or color. And you cut their hair, and they grow it out for you, and you pay them. And then 6 months later, you bring them all back in, and you redo it, do something else. And you photograph it. And they basically become the face of what you do. And they're super important. So I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing. It's like, I'm combing it, seeing where the weight is. Like, that's amazing. For me, this looks like super French. Like, no sideburn, really strong. But then it's like, you can change it. And now it looks, to me, now it looks English. It's a bit more like Rolling Stones. Could be the Beatles, but I think Stones had better. I think Stones had better hair. I'm sure that's gonna like light off a controversy.
I agree.
But, I mean, you guys agree? Stones had better hair.
Jade would like to know what all products did you use for this?
Okay, so far, who was it?
Jade.
Okay, Jade. So far, the only thing in Elle's hair is Essential Tonic by Arnco Blue. I don't know if you guys can see this it's so shiny, and it's not shiny because it's wet. And that's one thing I do love about it, is it puts a little bit of slip to the hair, but doesn't make it slimy. It still feels like hair, but I can still section with it, which I love. And when it dries, doesn't have that grease that some primers can have. But it just delivers a ton of hair. I could just hand dry this and she'd be fine, right?
Joshua asks, will you change your body position when you are in service and teaching?
You know what, Joshua, I'll do anything you want. Actually, I don't know what I don't understand the question, Josh, sorry, pal. But I'll change my body positioning for teaching, yes, so that you hopefully guys can see it in the camera, than I would if I was just doing this in the salon. Because when you teach, you gotta get out of the way so people can see. So you have to do it differently.
Bina wants to know what country we're in.
We are in the US of A. And before anybody asks, we're okay. I've had so many of my friends overseas in Europe, and a buddy of mine in Russia, and they keep texting me, you guys all right? Like, I don't want to talk about it. So I don't want to talk about like the last year. Like 2020 didn't happen. Any of you guys who own businesses, you'll agree with me. It's like you're gonna take your 2021 to the accountant, but you're gonna compare it to 2019, not 2020.
Yes.
Like, I didn't even want to file taxes for 2020. But I don't know if you guys can see, like, I'm moving this hair. It's not just me wasting time. I'm actually drying it with my hands. But when I say, and we say at R&Co, that we don't want a haircut to do one thing, we want it to do everything. That's what I'm looking for. It's like, can I push it off to this side? Can I push it off to that side? Will I be able to push it back? Will she be able to wear it forward? Will she be able to curl it? Will she be able to just let it air dry? Those are all the things I'm looking for. And I'm also checking weight. So there's this bit right here that I'm like, no, it's not gonna work. So what do we do about it? If it doesn't work, get rid of it. There's a guy trained with named Raymond McLaren. He's an editorial guy now. But Raymond said something to me like 25 years ago that is still stuck in my head now. I was struggling with a piece just behind the ear, just similar to this. And he came over behind me. And if you know who Raymond is, he's from Glasgow. He's Howard McLaren's brother. He always had like this massive beard. And he came over and he stuck his head on my shoulder. And he's like, is that piece bugging you? And I said, yeah. He goes, cut it off. I was like, what? He goes, cut it off. And so I did. He goes, does it bug you anymore? I said, no. He goes, move on. Because he knew I was gonna waste so much time on that one piece that if we just got rid of it, I wouldn't be fixated on it. And it was absolutely right. And that's what's great about when you have mentors, is they give you those things. Cool, now I'm happy. So right now, I'm just gonna use something. This is Waterfall, which is a moisture and shine cream. So basically, in layman's terms, it's a leave-in conditioner on steroids. And I just used a drop. But what's nice about Waterfall is it doesn't have any weight. It's like I just took all this weight out of her hair. Why on earth would I want to put it back? Which is what we have to think about when we're dealing with product. Product is a tool. It's exactly like our scissors, our razor, our brushes. And you have to pick the right tool for what you want to have. Great thing about product is that product does one of two things. You're either starching the hair or you're softening it. If I need grip, volume, I'm gonna starch the hair. If I need to soften it, collapse it, I'm gonna soften the hair. And so think of it that way. And when you go through your products, what does what? Because the starch is in varying degrees, light starch, medium starch, strong starch. Then your softening is in varying degrees as well. So this is just a light softening.
Deanna would like to know if this product is available in Canada.
Yep. Yes, absolutely. I can't remember the name of the distributors though. I think we have one distributor for the west side of Canada and then another distributor for like Toronto. But I can't remember the names off the bat. I'm sure somebody from R&Co is going to pop in here with that answer. They're really good about that. So I'm gonna get to the part where I can't talk, so I got a blow dryer. But all I'm gonna do is just power dry this in no particular fashion. I'm not gonna blow it back, but I'm not gonna blow it forward. I'm just gonna let it do its thing so I can see what it does naturally. Cool? Be back in a sec. Just drying it with the growth pattern. and that the high dive or waterfall, excuse me, is just giving me enough control without dictating what her hair is going to do. It's just keeping it together. The other thing is that I think a lot of times with shorter hair, we get too heavy-handed. We get right in there with the brush right away, and it ends up looking like a bouffant. And then we're trying to break it back down. That's why we dry the hair first, because you can't style wet hair. You can dry wet hair, but you can't style it unless you're doing like a wet look. But we have to get it dry so that we can style it, because it's like fabric. Like, you can't iron a wet shirt. Like, you can just dry it, and then all of a sudden it's dry, and then you can press it where you want it. So get it almost completely dry before you start working it. It'll make life so much easier. So what I'm gonna do is I just wanna stretch this shape out a little bit more. So what I'm gonna do is put my nozzle back on my dryer. What time is it?
It is 11.
Oh, almost. We've got like 2 minutes. Mm-hmm. So what I'm gonna do is grab the best round brushes in the world, R&Co round brush. And I'm just gonna stretch this out real quick. There's that. Now, I'm just gonna take a little bit of spray. This is the Featherlight Hairspray by Blue. Just to finish it up for you, so you get a finish, because I'm gonna keep going with this and I'm gonna take photos. And then they'll be up on my Instagram, Douglas_McCoy72, if you guys wanna check it out. I'm gonna take this ugly thing off of you. It's actually not ugly. It's a great tape. Now we have modern version of the halo. See here? It's just super cool, right? But it will do anything. She can tuck it and get a whole different look. I want to thank you guys for joining me. I want to thank Elle. Thank you.
Thank you
so much.